ultimately, the first part of this is understanding that it's a diagnostic procedure. It's so that we can get better information to further discuss with you about what the best treatment and management strategy is for your aneurysm. At Boston Children's Hospital, we generally do angiograms under general anesthesia to make the patients as comfortable as possible and get the best quality images as possible. What that means is that you will have a breathing tube while you're completely asleep during the procedure, and that we'll take it out after we're done with the procedure. This means that the night before, we do ask you not to eat, but we would typically like you to continue all your medications. If you have questions about that, please ask the nurse and the doctors at your pre-op visit, and you can also ask your neurosurgeon. On the morning of the procedure, you'll check in the interventional radiology area. You'll meet a number of people who will be taking care of you during the day. This includes the neurosurgeon, who you likely have already met before. They'll review again what's going to happen during the day, as well as the risks, the benefits, and why to do this procedure. You'll also meet the anesthesiologist and their team. They'll make sure that you're comfortable as you begin to start the procedure, and also make sure that you're fully asleep during the procedure, and they'll wake you up at the end of the procedure. You'll meet the nurses and the IR technologists who will be taking care of you during the day and make sure that you're safe and coordinating all of your care, whether it's in the angiography suite and also in the recovery area. After you've talked to all of them, you'll have signed some consent forms for this procedure as well as for the anesthesia care. They'll bring you back to the angiography suite, which will look just like this. You'll see things like the anesthesia machine, which takes care of your heart, your lungs while you're asleep, and also big devices like this, which is the image that takes an x-ray and shows us where the contrast is flowing and tells us the size, shape of the normal blood vessels, any abnormal blood vessels, and how the flow proceeds through all these vessels. We use big monitors like this one that allow us to see everything in high definition and in magnified views to really understand what's going on before we finish the procedure. Typically, after you leave the preoperative procedure area, we'll have your parents wait in an area of the hospital where they're comfortable, but they will be waiting about 3 hours before the doctor's finished and has thought through the pictures and discusses with them what the findings are. When they're talking to the doctor, you will be waking up and you'll be moving to the recovery area. At that time, we'll have taken the breathing tube out, as well as all the tubes that we use to look inside the blood vessels of the head and neck and the brain. You'll have a silly dressing that'll be on your leg that's a little sticker that holds pressure there, in addition to us having held pressure a few minutes at the end of the procedure. Typically, people can go home after a couple of hours lying flat, and usually that means in the early to mid-afternoon, patients are heading home from their angiogram.